Hello, my name is Yurong Jiang. I'm from LinkedIn Media Infra. Latency has been a popular topic for live, but have you ever measured the live latency in the wild? Today, we are going to discuss this topic. Here's the agenda for today. First, introduce the component of a typical live stream, and then we'll capture the type of latencies that we are going to discuss. After that, we will discuss how we perform those measurements technically. And finally, we will share some of the lessons that we learned from the process. So let's take a look at a classic live stream workflow. You have the producer capturing the content, pushing to the ingestion, where we have the encoding and origin for serving, eventually through the CDN to the client devices. So we are not going to talk about the glass-to-glass latency here because we don't really have the control over the contributing encoder. Instead, we are focusing on the three latencies along the pipeline. The processing latency is the time between the video frame arrives at the ingestion server to the video frame ready for serve from the origin server. The ingest to the CDN server latency is the video frame arrives at the ingest server to the video frame obtained from the CDN with the same timestamp. The ingest to the render latency is the time between the video frame arrives at the ingestion server to the video frame get displayed to the phone. So how do we measure those latencies? When the video gets transported and transcoded and delivered through the pipeline, the media timestamp could be maintained across all those steps. So the key idea here is to maintain and track those media timestamps across the stack. So first, we're going to talk about how we measure the processing latency. The processing latency measures the latency of the video frame gets through the ingestion all the way to the origin server. So the idea behind this is to manipulate the media box to carry the clock time through the ingest to the encoding. So when the video frame arrives at the ingest, we note down the clock time and package it in the PRFT box for the fragment MP4. We keep the PRFT box through the encoding process. When we put the transcoded fragment MP4 into a serving manifest, we extract the PRFT box and compute the latency with the current clock. So we have the processing latency measured. Now we're looking at latency from the ingest to the CDN serve. For the ingest to the CDN serve, we actually are measuring the time between the video frame arrives to the ingest to the time that frame with the same timestamp downloaded by the client. There are a lot of factors that players could introduce when they're trying this step. For example, there can be network issues or some of the device configuration causing the device not rendering the frame in a very efficient manner. This could contribute to the calculation skews. So in order to get a reliable and clean ingest to CDN serve latency, we need a more reliable and controllable client. To achieve that, we take the approach to have a server in the cloud to download the data from the CDN directly. So we call it cloud watcher here. So the key idea here is to watch for the video segment with the consistent media timestamp from the ingest to the cloud watcher. Let's take a look at a simple example here. Assume that video data arrives at the ingest with media timestamp PTS1. And after all those process and the delivery, the video frame with the same timestamp gets to the cloud watcher at clock ATS2. With assumption that the media timestamp is consistent, the actual latency is ATS2 minus ATS1, as simple as that. Now the question is, how do we get the timestamp from the ingest to the consumption end? To achieve this, we are bringing an event pipeline into the space which transports the ingest timestamp information to the cloud watcher. When the cloud watcher gets the information from the pipeline, the cloud watcher also tries to get the data from the CDN and parse the minutes time and the clock time of the data acquisition. So we just say that if they say two media timestamps are consistent, we simply have a clock delta here, which is a latency. So in practice, we cannot always have the media timestamp exactly the same in two places. In this case, we will introduce a media timestamp offset. The actual latency should be clock difference compensated with the media timestamp offset here. So we have discussed how we measure the latency from the edge server. So now, how can we extend this measurement to the client side, which has more uncertainties? So the ingest to the render latency describes the delay from the video frame arrived at the ingest to the time that the video frame get rendered at the devices. So similar to the ingest to the to serve latency, we leverage the event pipeline to pass through the timestamp information from the ingest. On the player side, getting media timestamp is a little bit tricky. So we are looking at another direction that we look at the edge relative timestamp for playback. What that means is we always look at the latest playback time for this entire manifest. So similar to the ingestor event, we have the player capture the timestamp. We do not want the player to take additional computation load. So we let the player to report the captured timestamp through its regular event pipeline. And eventually we have two event pipeline joined in an event processor, which handles the latency computation. Recall that when we calculate the ingest to serve latency, we have the pipeline delay and the media timestamp offset. Similarly, we have two latencies here. So the clock delta and the media timestamp offset. Note that we are looking at the relative timestamp from the player. We still need to adjust it with a video start timestamp. With this, we can get the accurate media timestamp offset here. Finally, the latency is just very similar to what we have previously. The difference between the clock delta and the media timestamp offset. Okay, so we have discussed enough technical stuff. Here are some of the lessons we learned from the process. First, those videos must be live in all computations. Otherwise, the result will be inaccurate. The second, the consumption clock in the consumption end needs to be ahead of the ingestion event clock. Otherwise, the result cannot really reflect the real delay here. As you can imagine that the media data hasn't get to the pipeline, you are calculating the latency for them. So it's definitely not going to be accurate. And third, the latency calculation turns out to be more accurate if the sampling rate from both player and the ingest gets higher. And finally, the player should report the live edge timestamp all the time. If it's not going to report that, the latency will be highly skewed. I want to share my acknowledgement to all the collaborators from both LinkedIn and the Microsoft Azure Media Service. The work cannot be done without any of them. And thank you. Yeah, I just want to conclude the talk, and I'm happy to take any questions.